What's up, everyone? How's it going? Bishop back here with another video. And guys, we know what's going on right now. We know it's the DNC convention that's going on right now, and it's got to be talked about. I know everybody's talking about it. I'm trying to keep up with it as well. And I want to talk about some things, too, that's going on with it. I'm trying to do the best that I can to keep up with it here, but I'm coming in later after the fact. Unfortunately, I can't stay up and do this live as much as I would love to, but I'm going to have to do the best that I can here. But I'm going to give some my outtake a little bit here on what I've seen so far on basically the highlights, clips, and stuff like that from night one, and about Joe Biden's speech, his farewell speech. Lord knows I wasn't staying up till 11 o'clock, you know, to try to watch that for an hour or so. Sorry, I have to get up early in the morning for my other job. But this here, JD Vance is going to give his outtake with Jesse Watters here about this low energy convention, man. I'm not kidding. This is what he says on here. He's pretty good. He's pretty spot on with it, you know, as what they talk about. And if you haven't seen it, we're going to recap it again. I'm going to bring it up and then give my two cents on it. And then, you know, we'll go from there, though. But let's take a look at this here with Jesse and JD.
Ohio Senator and the Republican nominee for Vice President JD Vance joins me now. I just have to tell you, Senator, the vibe here compared to Milwaukee is so different. It's not the same energy. It's not the same type of people. Exactly. What do you expect to see this week at the Democrats' convention?
Well, first of all, Jesse, keep your head on a swivel, because I know there are a lot of pro-Hamas protesters out there. So you gotta keep your eye on your six,
man. I mean,
man.
They're also giving out vasectomies for free, so I gotta really pay attention.
Yeah, well, sure. It is funny. The Democrats accuse me of lying when I say that they're anti-child and they schedule free vasectomies at their convention. I don't know what to take from that, Jesse.
I had a pause. He's right. I mean, I've never seen anything like this before, guys. Take a look at this crap here real quick in this. And you tell me, where is my feet at? Come on. It is. Right here. Tell me, who the hell, I've never seen this before. I swear to God, I've never seen anything, even thought of, or anybody even thought of something like this, to having a mobile vasectomy and abortion clinic. Man, I know this thing exists, okay? I know that. But it's crazy that this thing would pull up at the DNC. This is outside the DNC here, okay? This is one at the RNC. But here at the DNC, and Dr. Colleen, is it McNicholas, said Planned Parenthood planned to do about 10 vasectomies on Monday. That's yesterday. Like I said, I'm a day or late after day one. I'm doing here the recap here on day two. That's crazy, man. That's crazy. And this is the thing, too. Democrats, like you said, they call them crazy when they say they're anti-kid. And it's like, everything I've seen so much, man, for how many years now from Democrats have always been ultimately, you know, anti-population, like population control, everything else, what you see. It's insane, man. It's insane. But let's get back to this video.
See, but look, yeah. I think the reason the energy is different, Jesse, is because these guys know that they're running a candidate who's fundamentally a phantom. There's no actual evidence that Kamala Harris knows what she believes. She's not talking to the media. And her entire argument so far, of course, scripted via a teleprompter, Jesse, is that if you elect her president, she will somehow fix the inflation and border crisis that was caused by her leadership and promoted by her policies. So the entire idea that Democrats can run this fake campaign for another 80 days, where their argument is fundamentally that Kamala Harris has nothing to do with the administration, where she's the vice president, Jesse,
still
just doesn't make a whole lot of sense. And I think that's why the Democrats' convention is low energy. I'm sure the Hamas protesters don't help.
When you hear Kamala Harris says she wants to pick the price of bacon, she's going to say what cheese costs in Cincinnati. She's going to say what a head of lettuce is going to cost in Las Vegas. How do you guys process this? You're running against someone that's just completely out of touch with how capitalism works.
Exactly.
Well, you know, Jesse, it's a scarcity versus a prosperity mindset. I think Kamala Harris's basic approach is that she's going to increase the cost of fuel, increase the cost of food, increase the cost of housing, and then try to use her government magic wand to control the prices that people are charged for things. And I think you contrast that to Donald Trump's prosperity mindset, which is we're going to unleash American energy, we're going to unleash American workers, we're going to reduce the regulatory burden so that we can make more things in America and drive down the costs using the ingenuity and the talent of American workers. It's just a totally different approach. And I don't think that any person believes that Kamala Harris can wave a magic wand and bring down the price of bacon. I do think that we believe that she can wave her magic wand and actually make things even worse than she's already made them, which is why Americans are not going to buy into this idea that Kamala Harris deserves a promotion, Jesse. It just doesn't make sense. Just one more point on this price control issue, Jesse. This has been tried in multiple different countries by failed governments, and what it does is it makes the problem even worse. We know what we need to do to bring down the cost of American food and American housing. We just need to enable Americans to do more without the government controlling how they live their lives. That is the path to prosperity here, and it's shameful and ridiculous that Kamala Harris doesn't want to try it out.
You've seen the Republican Party really unite behind this ticket, and you saw that unity there in Milwaukee. The Democrats here are saying they're united, but Biden's hightailing it out of here after he speaks tonight. The Obamas hate Biden. Biden hates Nancy. Nancy's not talking to Joe. The Clintons are here. It's a disaster. Do you think the Democrats are as unified as they say they are? We just heard Don Lemon in Cincinnati talk to a slew of African-American voters. Half of them in Cincinnati say they're going Trump.
No, I don't think that they're united at all, Jesse. Again, it's all a phantom. It's all a mirage. Remember, a month ago, these are the guys who were telling us, backed up by the media, that Joe Biden, who couldn't complete a sentence, was Albert Einstein, right? He's the most brilliant president that we had ever had. And the minute it became obvious that he was political dead weight, they threw him overboard, and they're not trying to pick up the pieces, Jesse. I think that we've just witnessed in this country a month-long campaign to completely separate Kamala Harris from the administration where she is the vice president. It takes a lot of aggressive lying and a lot of shamelessness to pull it off, but you don't feel good when you look at yourself in the mirror after lying about Kamala Harris's record for the past month. And so I think Democrats just recognize this doesn't make any sense. Our entire pitch to voters is elect Kamala Harris, the person who's been vice president for 3.5 years, and she'll change all the bad policies. I think they all realize, and this convention really drives it home, they don't really have a leg to stand on.
All right. And you and Donald Trump are going to be driving that message home as you hit all these battleground states this week. JD Vance, thanks so much for coming on Primetime. Good luck out there.
Click here to subscribe to the Fox News YouTube page to catch our hottest interviews and most.
That's it. It's no joke, man. It is no joke. And like you said, I don't know how they honestly think they're going to run on this thing as far as what she's done past three and a half years going into this election and think this is a winning ticket. I mean, they're trying like hell. They know, you know, you got state media on their side covering, running cover for them. They're not asking any tough questions. And at some point she's going to have to sit down and answer some questions. She's going to have to get an interview or something. I swear to God, the tactic they're using is just wait till a debate that she wants that was set up between Trump and Biden. She wants that style of it set up. Wait till that debate's over. And then after that, She's saying that she'll agree. She's not agreeing to any more debates. You know, she's going to try to kill it on this one here as much as she can and then duck and dodge the media all the way to November 4th or 5th to Election Day. Okay? You know this coming. You know that's what she's going to do. She's already doing it now, talking about, what, 2 weeks ago, a week ago, we're going to sit down and take questions at the end of the month. How come you ain't taking questions now? You've been in this thing now 3 weeks. You haven't taken any questions at all. You haven't gone anywhere. And the one question that you did take, talking about your price control crap and how you're going to turn your ROI in, and then the return of the ROI of what you're going to get on what the government's going to invest in, was utterly stupid. She looked like a moron, basically economic illiterate, trying to explain this.
Economic policies last week.
Yeah.
Can you explain how you're going to pay for those, and can you give us a sense of what other policies you want to unveil going forward?
Sure. Well, I mean, you just look at it in terms of what we are talking about, for example, around children and the child tax credit and extending the EITC. That is, it's at $6,000 for the first year of a child's life. The return on that investment in terms of what that will do and what it will pay for will be tremendous. We've seen it when we did it in the first year of our administration. We reduced child poverty by over 50%. So that's a lot of the work. And then what we're doing in terms of the tax credits, we know that there's a great return on that investment. When we increase home ownership in America, what that means in terms of increasing the tax base, not to mention property tax base, what that does to fund schools, again, return on investment. I think it's a mistake for any person who talks about public policy to not critically evaluate how you measure the return on investment. When you are strengthening neighborhoods, strengthening communities, and in particular the economy of those communities, and investing in a broad-based economy, everybody benefits, and it pays for itself in that way.
So, there you go. Like I said, man, she has absolutely no economic clue how this thing works at all. She has no clue how just basic economics 101 works. Okay. None. And it hasn't learned from anything when the government gets involved with price controls and how it just turns into an epic failure. I mean, you can go back over decades back. I mean, look at what happened in Russia. It happened in Venezuela here as of recent here for a while. Hell, this even happened here in our own country with Richard Nixon back in 1971. And the massive backlash from that crap once he lifted it, because it only lasted 90 days. So just imagine that. The backlash that happened had lasted 90 days, man. It had affected this country for, what, 2 years, 3 years for a price control for 90 days? It's insane, man. She has no clue. She has no clue what the hell she's doing. But she's got that deer in the headlight look trying to explain something and knowing that she can't. And she's going to basically try to explain it and BS her way all the way through it. It's ridiculous, man. Like I said, I'm going to do the best I can to cover this stuff, too. You know, I know I'm coming a day late, but I'm trying to stay on it as much. And I honestly, I can't stay up and just watch this thing every single night all night and have my blood pressure going through the roof, you know, just listening to the onslaught of nonstop lies coming out of the DNC, man. I just can't. Even with Biden's speech last night, you knew what was coming with this crap anyway. They wait and push him all the way to 11:30, and it was shocked when he come out. I didn't even stay up for it. I went to bed. I was like, I got to get up in the morning. I'm not sitting up here. And on top of that, I know what's going to come out of this dude. Anyway, he's already bitter and pissed off how he got stabbed in the back. Yeah. Okay. This is your party. So, and then that speech, like, where I hear, I listened to the highlights all day today about it. And I was like, I thought about it later at the end of the day when I'm sitting there just trying to catch as much of it as I can. I said, you know what? I'm glad I didn't stay up for that crap. So, and they did it on purpose. They held him out, pushed him all the way back to 11:30. Most of the people are in bed at sleep, you know. So then they'll just catch clips and highlights of it, though, instead of staying up watching. And I was even shocked the fact that his ass was up at 11:30 at night doing this. I thought he was only doing business from, what, 10 to 4? Or something like that, damn near banker's hours or whatever. Whatever, man. The DNC is a joke. Democrats are a joke. Unbelievable frauds. I've been saying for years and years and years, man, they are just total frauds. Completely full of shiznit. So anyway, leave it in the comments below, man, and tell me what you think about this whole deal with the DNC. I will see. I will see if I can stay up the last night of this crap and see what I can get out of it. Especially when I guess, you know, Kamala, Camel Toe, whatever. Who gives a crap about her damn name? She's a total fraud anyway. I'll try to see if I can stay up and watch the BS coming out of her mouth too, as usual. Of course, you know it's going to be scripted because she sure as hell can't talk freely without a prompter, teleprompter, because you know how that goes. So, but anyway, guys, let me know in the comments below what you think on this. I will get back to the next one here, and I will see you here very soon on the next one here. Peace.